गुड मॉर्निंग डियर कैडेट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू एडजॉर्प्शन आइसोथर्म। जस्ट ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड हियर, एडजॉर्प्शन आइसोथर्म मीन्स, आइसो मीन्स सेम, थर्म मीन्स टेम्परेचर, मीन्स टेम्परेचर रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टेंट। एक्चुअली व्हाट इज एडजॉर्प्शन आइसोथर्म, सो ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड हियर, एडजॉर्प्शन ऑफ एडजॉर्बेट में बी गैस आर कंसनट्रेट सोल्यूशन ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ एडजॉर्बेंट डिपेंड्स अपॉन प्रेजर एट सेचुरेशन पॉइंट आर एट इक्विलिब्रियम। सो ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड, स्टडी ओनली आई टोल्ड यू द इफेक्ट ऑफ प्रेजर ऑन एडजॉर्प्शन। सो व्हाट इज द इफेक्ट ऑफ प्रेजर ऑन एडजॉर्प्शन, द रेट ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन इंक्रीजेस विद द इंक्रीज ऑफ प्रेजर इफ टेम्परेचर रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टेंट। सो एक्चुअली व्हाट इज द एडजॉर्प्शन आइसोथर्म, एडजॉर्प्शन आइसोथर्म इज नथिंग बट ए ग्राफिकल रिलेशन बिटवीन एक्सटेंट ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन एंड प्रेजर एट कॉन्स्टेंट टेम्परेचर। सो इट इज रिटन हियर, एडजॉर्प्शन आइसोथर्म इज नथिंग बट ए ग्राफिकल रिलेशन, ग्राफिकल प्लॉट बिटवीन एक्सटेंट ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन। एक्सटेंट ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन कैन बी रिप्रेजेंटेड बाई एक्स बाई एम एंड प्रेजर एट कॉन्स्टेंट टेम्परेचर। सो ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड हियर, वॉट इज एक्स हियर, एक्स इज मास ऑफ एडजॉर्बेट एंड एम इज द मास ऑफ एडजॉर्बेंट। सो जस्ट ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड, सो वॉट वी कैन से हियर, एडजॉर्प्शन आइसोथर्म इज नथिंग बट ए ग्राफिकल रिलेशन। यू कैन से मैथमेटिकल एम्पिरिकल रिलेशन आल्सो, मैथमेटिकल एम्पिरिकल रिलेशन आल्सो, दैट इज एडजॉर्प्शन आइसोथर्म। सो एडजॉर्प्शन आइसोथर्म इज नथिंग बट ए ग्राफिकल प्लॉट आर मैथमेटिकल एम्पिरिकल रिलेशन बिटवीन एक्सटेंट ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन एंड प्रेजर एट कॉन्स्टेंट टेम्परेचर। सो वेयर एक्स इक्वल टू मास ऑफ एडजॉर्बेंट एंड एम इक्वल टू मास ऑफ एडजॉर्बेंट। नाउ लेट अस सी द ग्राफ। सो डियर कैडेट्स, नाउ ग्राफिकल प्लॉट। सो जस्ट सी दिस साइड ओ बाई एक्सिस आई हैव टेकन एक्स बाई एम। वॉट इज द एक्स बाई एम, अमाउंट ऑफ गैस एडजॉर्ब आर एक्सटेंट ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन एंड ओ एक्स एक्सिस आई हैव टेकन प्रेजर। सो जस्ट सी इफ यू सी केयरफुली, इनिशियली विद द इंक्रीज ऑफ प्रेजर वॉट इज देयर, द एक्सटेंट ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन इज इंक्रीजिंग एंड द मूवमेंट इट रीचेस टू दिस पॉइंट, देन वॉट इज देयर, द रेट ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन मीन्स एक्सटेंट ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन इज मैक्सिमम एंड आफ्टरवर्ड्स वॉट इज देयर, देयर इज नो इफेक्ट ऑफ इंक्रीज ऑफ प्रेजर ऑन एक्सटेंट ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन। सो जस्ट सी दिस इज द मैक्सिमम पॉइंट पीक एट विच द रेट ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन मीन्स एक्सटेंट ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन इज मोर एंड आफ्टरवर्ड्स वॉट इज देयर, दिस ग्राफ इज ऑलमोस्ट फ्लैटेंड। इट मीन्स वॉट इज देयर, इवन इफ यू आर इंक्रीजिंग द प्रेजर देन ऑल्सो द रेट ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन आर एक्सटेंट ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन विल नॉट इंक्रीज। सो दिस पॉइंट इज नोन एज सेचुरेशन पॉइंट एंड द प्रेजर रिस्पॉन्सिबल आर प्रेजर प्रेजेंट एट दिस पॉइंट इज नोन एज सेचुरेशन प्रेजर। मीन्स एट दिस प्रेजर, ऑलरेडी आई हैव रिटन हियर, प्रेजर एट विच द रेट ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन एंड रेट ऑफ डिजॉर्प्शन बिकम इक्वल मीन्स अमाउंट ऑफ गैस एडजॉर्ब इज इक्वल टू अमाउंट ऑफ गैस डिजॉर्ब। ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड हियर, वेन यू इंक्रीज द प्रेजर द एक्सटेंट ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन इज इंक्रीजिंग एंड रीचेस टू द मैक्सिमम पॉइंट, दिस इज द मैक्सिमम पॉइंट। नाउ जस्ट सी, एडजॉर्प्शन इज ए रिवर्सिबल प्रोसेस, टिल दिस पॉइंट द एक्सटेंट ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन वॉज हाइएस्ट, आफ्टर दिस पॉइंट वॉट वुड बी देयर, डिजॉर्प्शन विल ऑल्सो स्टार्ट एंड यू नो वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ डिजॉर्प्शन, डिजॉर्प्शन इज द प्रोसेस इन विच द एडजॉर्ब गैस लीव द सर्फेस ऑफ एडजॉर्बेंट। मीन्स वॉट इज देयर, इट इज नाउ गोइंग अवे फ्रॉम द सर्फेस ऑफ एडजॉर्बेंट। सो बैक ऑफ मीन्स रिवर्स ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन, रिजर्व मीन्स रिवर्स ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन इज नोन एज डिजॉर्प्शन। So now desorption also started. So when desorption started, then what is there? Whatsoever pressure you are increasing, what is there? Extent of adsorption will not increase, because whatever amount of gas will adsorb at the surface of adsorbent, same amount of gas will leave the surface of adsorbent. So this is the saturation point. Means here again I have written, amount of gas adsorbed is equal to amount of gas dissolved at constant temperature. So what we can conclude here? We can conclude here, adsorption isotherm is the graphical plot between x by m, that is extent of adsorption, and pressure at constant temperature. Initially, with the increase of pressure, the extent of adsorption increases and it reaches to the peak, pinnacle, and afterwards it become flattened. This graph become flattened, means now rate of adsorption, means extent of adsorption, will not increase whatsoever pressure you are increasing, because after saturation point reverse process, that is desorption, will also start. So this is the adsorption isotherm. Now scientists have tried to explain this adsorption isotherm in the form of empirical mathematical formulae. So basically there are two scientists who explained the adsorption isotherm. The first scientist was Friedlich. He also explained the adsorption isotherm in mathematical empirical formula way. And second scientist was Langmuir. So Langmuir adsorption isotherm is not given in 12th class syllabus, it is given in higher class. Friedlich adsorption isotherm is given. So now I will teach you Friedlich adsorption isotherm. So dear cadets, this is Friedlich adsorption isotherm. So actually Friedlich is the name of scientist. He gave mathematical empirical relation between extent of adsorption, means amount of gas adsorbed, and this side, what is there? Pressure. So this relation is known as Friedlich, as he has given only this relation. So it is what? It is the mathematical empirical relationship between x by m and pressure, where x by m equal to x, you know this one, extent of adsorption, x equal to mass of adsorbent, m equal to mass of adsorbent, and p equal to pressure. So just try to understand here, this is the graph. So just see, if you see clearly, so there are three areas. Now I am deleting this side so that the clarity of the graph would be more. Just see here. Try to understand here. Just see, in this graph clearly three reason is there. At low pressure, what is there? When pressure is less, so the extent of adsorption is increasing. This is intermediate pressure region. And this region is at high pressure region. So there are three reason in this graph. Ab now just see. At low pressure, what is there? At low pressure, x by m is directly proportional to p. So what we can write? X by m equal to k into p. So what we can say here? Extent of adsorption is directly proportional to pressure at low pressure. At low pressure, extent of adsorption is directly proportional. Now k equal to what is there? K equal to proportionality constant. Now this is the first case. What is the second case? At high pressure, what is happening? At high pressure, x by m is directly proportional to p, here 0, where p equal to 1. means at higher pressure x by m means here we can write means at high pressure x by m become independent from pressure means extent of adsorption will not increase now even though you are increasing the pressure. So that is why here I wrote P equal to 1 or P equal to here 0 raised to the power 0. Independent means pressure is no factor here. Now the most important area is range is at intermediate pressure range. So just see at intermediate pressure range. So this is the first case, this is second case. Now third case, I am explaining you, just wait. So as you have seen in intermediate range of pressure, x by m is directly proportional to fractional power of pressure, that is p raised to the power 1 by n. So try to understand here, the fractional power of pressure, that is equal to 1 by n, where n equal to whole number. What is this one? Whole number. And it depends on nature of adsorbate and adsorbent nature of adsorbate and adsorbent. And n, if what is the range of n? 0.1 to 0.5, that is the range of n, whole number. So try to understand here, we can say at intermediate range of pressure, the extent of adsorption, that is x by m, is directly proportional to the fractional power of pressure p raised to the power 1 by n. Now here one more thing we can write here, x by m equal to k p 1 by n, that also can be written. Dear cadets, just see, n equal to, actually this is the correct range here, 0 to 1, bracket right here, generally this is equal to, it is equal to 0.1 to 0.5. so don't get confused, means n equal to, don't think now, earlier I wrote exact this value, actually the range is 0 to 1, and generally it is equal to, means in between 0.1 to 0.5. so just try to understand here, at intermediate range of pressures, the most important range is this one only, intermediate range. At low pressure, what is there? With the increase of pressure, the rate of adsorption increases. At high pressure, the rate of adsorption or extent of adsorption almost become independent from the pressure. Means whatsoever pressure you are increasing, there is no increase in the extent of adsorption. At intermediate range, what is there? Variation is there. What is there? Variation is there. That is why, means when it is 0.1, what is the extent of adsorption, then 0.2 0.3, means you will get the sequential increase in the rate of or extent of adsorption with the increase of pressure. So this is the Freundlich adsorption isotherm. And there is a drawback, there is a limitation of this isotherm also. At higher pressure, it fails. At higher pressure, there is no role of Freundlich adsorption isotherm. So dear cadets, नाउ कैलकुलेशन ऑफ के एंड एन फ्रॉम एडजॉर्प्शन आइसोथर्म, दैट इज फ्रंट लिच एडजॉर्प्शन आइसोथर्म. एज आई टोल्ड यू द इंटरमीडिएट रेंज ऑफ प्रेशर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो एक्स बाई एम इक्वल टू के, हियर पी वन बाई एन. सो हियर टेकिंग लॉगरिदम from both side, taking logarithm from both side. So here what is there? Log x by m equal to log k plus 1 by n log p, that is there. Now just try to understand. We can write this equation like that also. Log x by m equal to 1 by n, 1 by n log k plus log p. Now this equation is equal to straight line equation, that is y equal to mx plus c. That is straight line equation, y equal to mx plus c. Dear cadet, this is log p and this is log k. Now we have to plot a graph between x by m and log p, then you will get graph like that. So if we plot a graph between x by m and log p, we will get straight line, but it will not pass from origin. This is o, x, this is y. What is this one? Here at normal pressure adsorption is taking place. Now try to understand here. As you know, select one point. You are very much aware about how to calculate the, so just see, select this point, this is there. Now here what would be there? Like that. Now this is A, this is B, this is C. So now tangent you have to calculate. Tangent equal to what is there? AB by BC, that is equal to slope. So now try to understand, this is intercept. What is this one? Intercept is equal to 1 by n, and intercept equal to k, and slope is equal to 1 by n. So in this way we can calculate the value of k and slope. So in this way, dear cadet, this is tan theta equal to AB by BC, that is equal to slope. Slope is equal to 1 by 1 and intercept is equal to log k. So with the help of this one, very easily we can calculate the log k value, k and n value. So that is the advantage in the Friend-Lich adsorption isotherm. And you know what is the meaning of k? K is a constant. And what is the n? N is the whole number. Means range of pressure you can calculate with the help of this one. So dear cadets, there is one more aspects of adsorption is here. What is that one? Just try to understand. As gases are getting adsorbed on the surface of solid adsorbent, in the same way solute of solution can also be adsorbed on the surface of solid adsorbent. I can give you so many examples. Just try to understand here. Make the solution of acetic acid in water. ओके, आर यू गेटिंग माई पॉइंट आर नॉट? एसिटिक एसिड एवरीबडी नो, एसिडिक एसिड शुड बी डिजॉल्व इन द वॉटर. सो नाउ द सोल्यूशन ऑफ एसिटिक एसिड विद द वॉटर इज रेडी. नाउ सेम सोल्यूशन इफ इट इज केप्ट इन कॉन्टेक्ट विद द चारकोल. सो द चारकोल इज हियर एडजॉर्वेंट, देन वॉट इज देयर? एसिटिक एसिड कंसंट्रेशन इन द सोल्यूशन विल डिक्रीज ओवर द पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. सो वॉट डज इट इंडिकेट? इट इंडिकेट्स दैट एसिटिक एसिड हैज बीन एड्सॉर्ब बाय द चारकोल. दिस इज द फर्स्ट एग्जाम्पल. सो वी हैव टेकन सोल्यूशन ऑफ एसिटिक एसिड. नाउ एसिटिक एसिड वॉज द सोल्यूट. नाउ दैट हैज बीन एड्सॉर्ब बाय द चारकोल. सो एड्सॉर्प्शन फ्रॉम द सोल्यूशन means who will be adsorbed from the solution? Solute will be adsorbed by the adsorbent. So there charcoal was the adsorbent and acetic acid was the adsorbate. See another example. That was the means previous example belongs to the liquid-liquid solution. Now I am taking you the sugar. Just try to understand sugar particle. The moment sugar particle is prepared in the sugar factories, do you know what is their color? Brown color. Why their color is brown? Because inside the sugar particle, sugar crystal, some organic dye is present. What is present? Sugar is itself an organic compound. You know, some organic dye is responsible for its brownish color. I'm now try to understand. So sugar particle is itself a example of solid solution, and now which is organic dye present inside the sugar particle, that is the solute. I'm now try to understand when same sugar particle is come into contact of bone charcoal. Which charcoal? Bone charcoal. Then what is there? Those organic dye which is responsible for the brownish color, they will be adsorbed by the charcoal. So what is the meaning of this one? And your sugar particle become colorless. So what is the meaning of this one? We can say solute particle in the solution can also be adsorbed by the solid adsorbent. So means the behavior of solution is very much equal with the behavior of gas, because gas was adsorbed earlier. Now solute of solution is also adsorbed. So the behavior of gas particle and behavior of solute particle in the solution is same. So for the gas particle, if Freundlich adsorption isotherm is valid, so in the same way for the solute particle, Freundlich adsorption isotherm is also valid. So just see, for them earlier you have written here P, now write here C. What is C here? C is equal to equilibrium concentration of solute. Equilibrium concentration of solute, that is C. And now you will ask, sir, in the solution what is the meaning of equilibrium? So just see, try to understand. Take water, start adding the sugar particle, sugar. So initially what would be there? Sugar particle will dissolve, but one stage will come when the dissolution of sugar particle in the given amount of water will stop. That is only saturation point. If further if you will add the sugar particle to the given amount of water, they will be settled down. So what is there? Earlier sugar was dissolving, and now sugar is now precipitating. So reverse process will start. So that point when reverse process means precipitation of sugar particle start, that is only equilibrium concentration. So at low pressure what is there? X by M means rate of adsorption, extent of adsorption is directly proportional to C. At higher pressure what is there? Rate of adsorption become independent from the equilibrium concentration, that is why C equal to 1. Everything is same, only in place of P you should write C. बट एट इंटरमीडिएट रेंज व्हाट इज देयर, के इक्वल टू सी मींस फ्रैक्शनल पावर ऑफ सी. इन द सेम वे यू कैन टेक द लॉगरिथम ऑन बोथ साइड एंड यू कैन कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ के एंड एन. सो आई एम टेकिंग दिस साइड ओनली, जस्ट सी, बाई टेकिंग लॉगरिथम लॉग ऑन both side, which one I am taking log? I am taking the log of this one, this equation at intermediate range of pressure. So what would be there? Log x by n, that is equal to log k plus 1 by n, here log c. So now we can write this one, log x by n equal to 1 by n log c plus log k. Now again this equation is equivalent to straight line equation, and that is equal to y equal to mx plus c. Same way you can plot graph, calculate the intercept and slope, and you can calculate the value of n. So what is the conclusion here? Not only gaseous particle get adsorbed on the surface of adsorbent, solute particle of solution can also be adsorbed at the surface of solid adsorbent. So dear cadets, in this way adsorption isotherm for the gaseous particle and for the solute particle I have completely completed. Now tomorrow I will teach you adsorption isobar and application of adsorption. In this way the half of the portion of this unit will be finished, and afterwards I will start the remaining portion of this one, that is catalysis and colloidal solution. So please keep noting this one. I am planning for the test also, means I will take the test from chemical kinetics, because that unit exclusively I completed. How I will conduct this one, I will inform you, and I am hoping that you are getting it properly. And now one point of time will come when you will get the videos only on Google Classroom. You will not get the videos on YouTube or school given link. So please enroll or download Google Classroom and register yourself as early as possible. Thank you.